Hi everyone, this is Ahmed. I'm a web analyst with more than 3 years of experience in web analytics. When I started learning about web analytics, I was an account manager and a business administration student, meaning that I did not have a technical background at all. That's why I decided to create this free course for non-technical users to help them master web analytics for free. At the end of this course, there will be a challenge for you to complete, and upon completion, you'll receive your course certificate that will come to you as a LinkedIn recommendations. I'll be sharing more details on that at the end of the course. Before starting with the course content, I want to highlight one important thing that you should be always aware of, which is I will rarely use any official definition for the tools that we will be using here or the topics that we'll be discussing as well. Main goal of that course is simplifying the learning. If you ever wanted to get an official definition of a product or a term that I have mentioned throughout this course, I highly recommend Googling it out and you will easily get the official definition. This brings us to the question, what is web analytics? I'd like to answer this question with an example. Let's say that you have a website and users visit that website. That website sells t-shirts. So the user journey typically would be visiting your website, as a product page to browse the products, adding a product to the shopping cart, then going to the checkout pages, and finally, or hopefully, purchase from your store. Not all of these users will purchase from your website. This is when web analytics comes in picture, where we will track these users who visit the store and collect all of the events they are performing so we can analyze it. Example, using Google Analytics, we can determine how many users visited a product page, how many users from those have added the product to the shopping cart, how many of them purchased from your store. This can help you analyzing the conversion rate for each step. Additionally, we can send that user action to several tools like Facebook, so your marketing team can target a specific group of users who added a specific product to the shopping cart. Web analytics have several areas and specialization that will take you some time to master. But in this course, we will be mainly focusing and talking about Google Tag Manager and how it works. Google Tag Manager and the example we just discussed is the tool that you will be using to capture the user behavior and sending them to an ad destination like Facebook or analytics destination like Google Analytics. Now that you have an idea about what is web analytics, here are the course content. First video will be about configuring your learning environment so you can implement everything that you learn in this course. The second video will be an overview of Google Tag Manager. Third video will be about the data layer, what is the data layer and how it works. Fourth video will be about Google Tag Manager variables. Fifth will be about Google Tag Manager tags. Lastly, we'll be talking about triggers. At the end of the course, there will be also a challenge, as mentioned, where I'll ask you to perform a specific set of actions that we have discussed and learned together in this course. And upon completion, I will send you a personal LinkedIn recommendation that says that you have completed the challenge in the proper way. I hope you enjoy learning and enjoy this course. See you in the next video.